Hello and welcome to another episode of Mid-Island Custom Diecast. My name is Evan and today we're going to be doing a Matchbox Dodge Challenger and in conjunction with Lee from Wee Little Cars for his Mopar Monday. Here we're going to take a look at what we're starting with. It's a plastic base sort of remake of the Superfast line from Matchbox. It's got the plastic textured roof, a little blower sticking out of the engine, and the yellow paint with that beautiful splatter design. So we're going to start by oiling up the rivet post ends here, the little mushrooms, and just a little oil and the big drill bit to pop those off. Take the base out. I'm going to get rid of these wheels immediately and swap them out down the road for some nicer wheels. Got the pink interior. There's the glass section. You can see it's held in with a couple of posts or little plastic mushrooms, and it fits on to the interior, and then it locks in at the back of the body with a couple of little posts there. Now the rivet posts, we're going to clean them up and make them fit nicely with the base. Another reason I'm doing this is so that when you put the base back on, the post doesn't stick out past it, and the screw when you put it in holds it in nice and tight. Here's a 1.7 millimeter drill bit, and we're just going to take that down deep enough to hold a 256 screw. I use a Phillips head, button head screw. Here are the screws now. And I use self-tapping screws, so normally I don't have to tap the holes. These ones were a little tight, but we got them in there. Here's the front one. Now we're off to the stripper with the body. Now, Chuck from Flying Valiant sent me a bunch of 3D printed parts, including a bunch of steering wheels. So, here I am putting one of them on here. Cut the old one off and file the little nub down so we have a nice flat surface to glue the new one to. And I wanted to separate these so that I could clean them up separately. So we take the same drill bit that I used to open the car, and I'm just twisting it by hand to remove the mushroom off the plastic and so that I don't go right through the roof. There we have the windshield. You see it's in pretty good shape, a little yellowed, but we're not going to do the peroxide treatment on that one because there is no sun and I'm waiting for a UV light. Anyway, here's the first round of paint stripping. I put it in the caustic soda and it literally took off the black splatters, and that's about it. So before I put it in the chemical stripping bath, I'm just going to run over it with some Scotch-Brite help. Hopefully that helps the stripper penetrate the paint. And here it is when it's out of the stripper. Pretty good, but you can see there is a lot of paint chips left to take off. So I went and bought a couple of actual Dremel brand wire wheels. And I'm going to be using those ones to remove the majority of the paint here. I'll show you a small sample off the trunk lid here. On the side you can see it's going to be no problem. This casting was in pretty good shape, but there were casting lines along from the front to the back all along the top there. So I've got a bunch of little needle files and we're just going to work our way up and down both of those. And around the fender flares front and back too were kind of ugly. This casting I think was maybe 93, and the quality was obviously lacking back then. So we've gone over all those sections with the files, and I figured instead of sanding by hand I would give it a shot with the Dremel with a little sanding disc to just clean off all the scratch marks from the files, and it worked pretty well. After the filing, we are going to go over it with a Scotch-Brite attachment for the Dremel. I do this on every build, usually followed with a steel wool, which I did in this case but didn't film. And here I've got a scribing tool because I ended up, I guess, not sanding too much, but I didn't think the panel lines were quite deep enough, so we're just going to scratch the panel lines a little deeper. Here, just test fitting the wheels. These are LODC wheels again. I bought a bunch of them and they're really, really nice and easy to work with. You can see in the slots there, I'm just pointing them out here. I put a couple little pieces of styrene to adjust the ride height because I guess the other wheels, the stock wheels, were a little bigger. But this drops the car a little bit lower to the ground and keeps the wheels in the wheel wells really nice. And it rolls decent, but not great. Here, the LODC wheels come with these disc brakes. They're so small to see and impossible to only paint the caliper, so I just paint them all so that you have a chance to see them through the wheel when you're looking at the finished product. All right, so the interior I gave a painted black first, and now we're just going to go over that little engine blower section with the Molotow burner chrome spray. The spray literally goes everywhere when you're working with it, but it does have a nice smooth finish. Not very much detail on the base of the chassis, just a lot of writing, but it does have the front grille and the back, the rear taillights. So we're going to paint this in black first of all. I like to paint all my bases black and then add detail from there. Now the body, we've already gone ahead and sprayed that with the Tamiya gray primer. And this is just a black base coat that I'm going to be using to spray a metallic finish over. It's not the Metal Cast or the Redline Shop, but it is this Rust-Oleum Metallic, and for $8 a can, I find it does the trick. If you do two coats of this, it really does give you a nice smooth metallic finish. There it is. And this is like a sea grass color. It's a semi-transparent paint from, I don't know, I can't remember. But I did see it in Diecast Show Customs, a video of his a few months ago. Anyway, I did two or three coats of this to get to the desired color. This is one coat, and we'll show you, we won't show you the rest, but you'll see at the end. So here we are going to paint the front grille, headlights, bumper. We're going to do that all in the chrome silver, Tamiya chrome silver. This stuff is finicky to work with. If it's partially dry and you go to brush a little bit more on, you'll end up brushing it off. So I put one coat on and then usually go back over again once it's dry. We got the side pipes here, going over them with some chrome as well. Both sides. We're just going to add a tiny little bit of detail into the interior. May or may not see it, but first we do the spokes of the steering wheel. That's in the chrome silver again. I did have the Sharpie out. I was going to try and do it with the Sharpie, but I just couldn't get the angle on it. This is sky blue, I think, from Tamiya. And I'm just doing the inner portions of the upholstery, I guess leather seats or whatever you want. I'm going to do the passenger, the driver, and the back seat with the blue in the middle just to give it a little extra something when you look at it. It is a convertible, so you can see in the interior pretty well when this is finished, but you can definitely see the seats. So there I left the armrest in the middle of the seat, and we're just doing the bench all the way across. And so the windshield needed a bit of polishing. No, there were no scratches or anything, but I did go over the front and back with the Flitz polish first, and now this is the Meguiar's Plastex polish. I do end up putting this in the pledge, revive it after I'm all done this step. It doesn't really need it, but we do it anyway. So here's the back Q-tip application, and then I end up buffing it out with a rag and cleaning it off. You can see it's already pretty shiny without the pledge, but here is the pledge, and as with everyone else who does this, you gotta wick the extra moisture off of the corners and top, make sure it doesn't pool or puddle on the windshield. And I've got a nice little piece of shop towel cut to the size of that container. We'll slap that in there and set it to dry overnight. Here we're doing the marker lights. You can see here I've already I've already gone ahead and clear coated, I got ahead of myself, but after that we put some chrome on the markers and some clear orange, and I managed not to screw anything up, so that's great. On the base, the chassis, the front grille, we're doing the headlights in white with a toothpick because they're super small. The grille gets the Nuln Oil, Citadel Nuln Oil. Really nothing beats the grille. Putting the Nuln Oil on the grille just looks fantastic. We also did all the little bits and pieces on the pipes here just to give it some added definition. The taillights, we do those in the Tamiya clear red. And when we're done that, we will have a look at what we started with. There it is with the black splatter paint job. And let's take a look at what we got to. This clear coat that we used here was a Varathane spray clear. Jim Silva has been talking about his Minwax clear for some time, and I've been jealous because I can't find it here. Apparently because of COVID, so the stores say. But this is a Varathane that is meant for wood. But man, if it doesn't look fantastic. This is literally one coat of clear, and really came out well. Anyway, I want to thank all you guys for watching the videos and the likes and the comments all the time. Please feel free to share the videos with friends and family and hit that like button again. And I will see you all next time.